on Jesus. And he said, He says, no evil shall be lightly spoken in my name. He said, you know what? Them that are with me are with me. Them that are scattered, they'll scatter the bride. Which means, glory to God, that he ain't worried about your denomination. God is bigger than our church. God is bigger than our office. Glory to God, God is bigger than, glory to God, our reputation. Jesus made himself no reputation. Glory to God, he humbled himself unto the death of the cross. And glory to God, we have attitudes. Glory to God, when we ain't called. But the Bible declares, unless you humble yourself, he that humbled himself shall be exalted. And what? Do season. And the truth of the matter is, God said, he said the church has, you know, in Ephesians, when you read Ephesians, the Bible says that every calling of the apostle, the prophet, the evangelist, the pastor, the teacher was given for the perfecting of the saints. Now, when you go to the book of Timothy, you know, that's the preacher's book, glory to God. When you go, glory to God, to Titus, that's the preacher's book. When you go to Peter, that's the preacher's book. He's correcting preachers, glory to God. And the scripture declares it like this. He says this. He says, you know what? Do not usurp your authority. He says, know that your master, which are in heaven, glory to God. You have a master. We don't supposed to beat the ones, glory to God, that don't know, glory to God. We supposed to feed them. How can you clean when you ain't coming? Amen? So the truth of the matter is that God says, the way the church is doing it, they're doing it wrong. I said, why are they doing it wrong? He says, because with love and kindness, I have what? Drawn thee. Can I tell you when I got saved? I was drinking. Can I tell you I was drinking? And God gave me a dream. And he gave me this dream, glory to God. He showed me where I was going to cut my hair. Apostle Thomas, remember, glory to God. He said, long hair, play them drums. Look bad, boy. Look bad, yellow boy. See my attention. Apostle McGill, glory to God. And God, glory to God, he said, you want to preach the gospel. No, I'm not going to preach the gospel. I said, no, because I don't want to do that because I seen how the church was handling the people. And I seen, you know, the Bible says that Paul, he got his stripes in the church. It was the church that wounded him. Amen. The Bible says that there was many stripes from the church. It was people that mistreated. I was reading Acts 18 and 19. When you get a chance, I want you to read it. The scripture says that he did many miracles. Glory to God. It was the people on the streets that received him better than the people in the church. Don't that sound right today?
Amen.
Glory to God. You have to go on the streets and talk to somebody. It seems like the people on the streets can relate to you better. It seems like, glory to God, when you call the pastors, the preachers, and the parents and different things, they're so busy, boasting on, glory to God, their roles, their titles, their achievements, their money, glory to God, this, that, and the third. Glory to God, when you go to people like Mary Magdalene, glory to God, they are kissing the feet of Jesus. They are not stopping worshiping. They're just saying, you know what, glory to God, I just thank God that you are in my presence. Glory, I don't know about you, glory to God, but God says also prophetically, it's time for you to discern your company. Because the truth of the matter is, you got people, glory to God, don't think a lick of you, glory to God. And you're trying to impress them, glory to God. But he says, I heard from you.
God, praise God.
What I found out, glory to God, is that the body of Christ, we have came to a point in a place in a position where we don't even forgive one another. Ooh, let somebody do something. We gonna gossip, we gonna slander their name. We gonna say, you know what, you don't need to be around them because this and that. But the Bible says this. He says, ye that are what? Spiritual should restore such a one with what? Not put your mouth on them. You wanna know how? By praying for them. Them that despise you, pray for them. Them that hurt you, them that, you know, it was a season where I couldn't read them scriptures, you know. That forgive them, don't let the sun go down upon your wrath. I couldn't read them scriptures because it was such a bitterness that was in me. Glory to God. Have you ever been there? Let's just be real. Glory to God. Peter said, how many times I got to forgive them? 70 times 7 a day. Damn. How many people have been there, glory to God, where with certain people, glory to God, that you was trying to figure out, like in Psalms 37, how come they sing blessed, glory to God, and I'm not blessed? Let's just be real, glory to God. God says, I want to turn your stony hearts into flesh again. Glory to God, you don't want to, glory to God, forgive, glory to God, certain loved ones, glory to God, because they mistreated you. The Bible says it like this, if you don't forgive them, I won't forgive you.
Amen.
We shout, we dance. 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter says, though you speak in tongues and you don't have love, he said you are like a tingling cymbal, which means that you're just making noise. With your lips, you say stuff, but your heart is far from it. I hear what you're saying, but I don't receive what you're saying. Because you have this funk on you. You have this odor on you that I can't stand. Church, it's time for us to get it right. God says, you know what? He said, son, I'm gonna tell you what the Holy Ghost does. He do more than give you, you know, the evidence of speaking in tongues. I remember it was a time, glory to God, where me and my wife, we got into it. The Holy Ghost rebuked me and said, hey, go to your wife and tell her you sorry. I said, but she was wrong. I was right. I said, go to her and tell her you was wrong. You sorry. That's what the Holy Ghost does, right? I know what the Holy Ghost does. When you really got the Holy Ghost, you ain't going to just shout and dance, but it changed your lifestyle. Amen? When you really got the Holy Ghost, you know how to love people that you know means evil. Listen to this. He said, it's 12 of you, right? And one of you is a devil. He never mistreated Judas. How many of you, when you find something out about somebody, you start treating them all evil and stuff? You start kicking them to the curb. That's not the love. That's not agape love that we always want God to give us. He said, who obtained much mercy should give mercy. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, church, come on. We have to love one another. We got to love, you know, there are friends, glory to God, that you say, you know, we have a reason to hang with them no more because they ain't saved, they just a bunch of sinners. Well, it took somebody to pray for you. Why now that you are saved, you can't pray for them? Well, why now that you are saved, you can't call on them and say, you know what, I'm sorry. I don't care. You know what? The Apostle Peter. And this is what happened to him in 2012. I'm going to tell you the truth. See, some of you tell lies. I'm going to tell you the truth. In 2012, in 2009, God came to me and thunder said, feed my sheep. I've called you to be a prophet to the nations. 2013, God started showing me the apostolic on my life. Glory to God. There's no wonder, glory to God, that Apostle Thomas' wife, I always say, Apostle, glory to God. When she sees that, I never tell nobody, glory to God. When I went to Amarillo, glory to God, it was an apostle that called me out to the front and said, glory to God, God has called you to help us. I have literally seen Jesus come to me face to face. Glory to God. So I know you be in the spirit when you be saying that, glory to God. Because the Bible says this. He said, flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but the spirit of what? My Father has revealed this to you. You got to be in the spirit to see people's true identity. Glory to God. So what happened, glory to God, in 2012, and I'm talking about Apostle Peter because, glory to God, we always think that apostles were exempt from sin, but the Bible says when Apostle Peter, glory to God, he had got through, glory to God, doing what he was doing, and Jesus already told him that he was going to curse. He was going to deny him. And then when the situation came, he started cursing. He said, I don't know this man. He literally started cursing. Now, how many people have anger issues that you ain't dealt with yet? The Bible says in Galatians 6, glory to God, I believe in the 12th verse, the Bible says, he hate them that are the quick to anger. Oh, Jesus. You say, well, you know what? God said, touch not my anointing. He also said, humble yourself too. Listen to this. They hit Jesus in his face. You get mad because somebody talking about you. You get mad because somebody have abused you. Well, how would you feel, glory to God, if you pray for mass people? Some of you have prayed for mass people. And you're mad at God, saying, God, how come they keep on turning on you? He said, they're a generation of survivors. Son, he says, when they don't receive it, he said, what? Shake the dust off. Shake the dust off. But some of you, glory to God, you don't know how to shake the dust without saying, I love you in spite of. Listen to this. Apostle Peter and Apostle Paul, when he got converted, the scripture says that, you know, he says, you know what, I'm not going to, he said, I'm going to take Mark with me. He said, you know what, I'm going to take Silas when they had to depart. But glory to God, when it came down to the apostleship, they still loved one another and they still understood, glory to God, that there's a calling and touch. But we make the anointed thing, glory to God, feel like we are the only anointed ones. He said, Elijah, there's 7,000 of the prophets that ain't bowed down to me. Amen. Don't you know the Bible says God will place somebody, put somebody in the office, and he will take somebody in office? We found that out with Judas. Who took Judas' office was Matthias. And then Paul came. Amen. So the truth of the matter is that we can't get beside ourselves and feel like because we have an office. Don't you know? In the days of Agrippa, glory to God. In the days of the king, glory to God, he was acting like, glory to God, he was big and bad, and the angel came and smote him dead. Ain't that what your words say? We can't, glory to God, get too big headed, glory to God, thinking that we are all dead. Amen. We ain't nothing but dirt. I heard my grandfather say that. We ain't nothing but dirt because we was made from the dust of the ground. Amen. Ain't nothing but dirt. Glory to God. You say, I'm going to argue with that. I'm better than dirt. Well, let's see. Let's see, glory to God, what happens when you die. Where they going to put you at now? My God ain't my fault. It's just what they do. We ain't nothing but dirt. Amen. So the truth of the matter is that, and Isaiah say, our righteousness is as what? Filthy rags. Amen. Our righteousness says, filthy rags. Our righteousness, listen to this. He says, your righteousness, he says, righteousness of men. He said, but unless you have the righteousness of God, the righteousness of God. Hallelujah. The truth of the matter is that, let me get back to 2012. So in 2012, you know, I got saved, I'm prophesying, seeing miracles, all types of stuff. Just like Peter, Matthew 10, the scripture says that Jesus, he anointed them, he called them, he chose them, the calling on their life, the anointing on their life, the office on their life. But guess what? Peter goes and denies Jesus. Hold on a second. I'm going to tell you the truth about God. Are y'all ready for this? I'm going to tell you the truth about God. You want to know why Paul said she died daily? The truth of the matter is because it's evil always present. You got to die. You got to die to your flesh. Amen? I'm going to tell you something. Moses did a 40-day fast, right? And tell me why he hit the rock instead of speaking to the rock. They let you know that your flesh is still alive. Listen to this. After Peter, glory to God, sinned the work, the goodness of God, he went and he cursed God. You can't tell me. The Bible says also, when you read 1 Kings, I believe the 3rd chapter, Solomon seen the Lord in a dream. And just because he seen the Lord, he wasn't exempt from sin. The Bible says right after that, it was women came in his life and turned his heart from God. Ooh, so what did that mean? That's why Peter came with the revelation, a righteous man scarcely making in. Don't you know Judas walked with Jesus? Don't you know he walked with Jesus? And he rejected Jesus? He betrayed Jesus? That's a dangerous thing. That's why the Bible says it's better to not know the way than to know the way. It's like the dog returning back to his what? Vomit. Do you hear me? Do you hear me, church?
Amen.
Joel came with a revelation. He says, you know what? He said, you priests. He said, you handmaid, you servants. He said, I want for you to weep from the porch to the altar. He said, I want for you to give your heart and not your garments. I want for you to repent. This is the hour of repentance. This is not the hour of shouting and dancing. This is the hour of repentance. This is the hour of crying out to God. The Bible says, when you see Israel lining up, know that the end is coming.